afternoon, everyone. We are number 9. Welcome to AADC News. I'm Angel.
I'm Josie.
Today, our first news is talking about
study highlights gender stress differences.
Negative news stories will found the children women reacting to stressful situations.
A study in Canada has found that women react differently to stressful situations after reading negative news stories such as reports of murder or rape. For the study, researchers collected a series of negative and neutral newspaper stories. Men and women were shown the reports and then put through a stressful stress test. The participants' levels of cortisol, a stress hormone, were constantly measured.
The researchers found that although negative news stories did not directly cause the women to feel stressed, they did make them respond more quickly and more aggressively to stressful situations later on. Men, on the other hand, were unaffected by the negative stories and their level of cortisol remained unchanged.
Although scientists have pointed out that this was a small study and that more research needs to be done, the findings are still interesting. Not only do they suggest a huge difference between the genders, but they could one day be used to improve health.
Professor Terry Murphy commented that women seem more reactive to stressors, but then they go on to outlive men. How do women manage to neutralize the effects of stress on their cardiovascular systems? An answer to that question will improve health for all of us.
Next up,
look for a job not at school. Have all the students out there found jobs yet? Foundation had discovered through its own investigation that most corporations hope that new graduates will have excellent foreign language ability, have graduated from a renowned school, achieve excellent grades for studying, and were involved in an internship or course experience. On the other hand, new graduates hope that corporations can provide things such as plenty of education and training, no more work hours, and so on. It is clear that there is a large difference between the perception on either side.
Many college students nowadays only seek to pass classes and place little emphasis on high schools. So it's already bad enough that their English ability is lousy. But the Chinese ability of many college students is worse than that of junior high school students. Students are also unenthusiastic about club activities at present. In action, some new schools have received very poor appraisals in business circles.
Yes, and many fresh graduates feel that it is the corporation's responsibility to teach them how to do their job. However, corporations feel that if they need to learn things, they should go back to school as there is no reason they should pay employees' salaries, but also taking care of them that they're still a student.
Yes, and we suggest that unless you have graduated from a renowned school, you should not rush to find a job. Take a year or so to improve your Chinese and English abilities and get at least 750 points on the TOEIC. Then acquire a few more certifications so that you can increase your chances of being accepted. For UTC News, I'm Josie.
I'm Angel.
Have a good night!